Hey guys, Tech Made Simple here, and we're reviewing the image of Galstileo on the GamePi 43. I reviewed his first image that I worked with, which was version 1 of Dragon Blaze, and it was a really great image. I liked it a lot. It worked with my GamePi 43 right out the box, which is very strange because a lot of the RetroPie images that I use involve me installing a script. But with Recall Box, as a lot of us know, and if you don't know, has the GPI controller drivers already implemented within the image. So if you do install it and you put it in your WaveShare device or RK controller or whatever may have you, that you have a GPI controller connected and it doesn't work, here's another way you can do it on a Windows PC. You can set up your network with either a yconfig file where you have your SSID and password, or you can do it the normal way within the settings. With a Bluetooth keyboard, you would go into your Windows Explorer and type in the IP address to your unit. That means to whatever your GamePi 43 or whatever unit you're using for a RetroPie game device, and you can enable the GPI controllers through there. I didn't have to do that, but that's another way that I've learned you can do it. And we're gonna check out this great image real quick. It has a lot of goodies on it. So, let me just get this right into the camera where you guys can see it. Now the GamePi 43 does have a teeny speaker. I plan on changing that speaker myself by installing a new one. But right off the bat here, with Galistio's new image, hope I'm not butchering your name, it has now categories for your arcade. So as you can see, it does have a list of games, but just the favorites, you know, like Midway, Konami, Nintendo, never heard of Mitchell Corporation, Namco, PGM, which is one of my favorites because it's kind of like a Neo Geo, and I'm a Neo Geo fan. Sammy, Sega. So a lot of the games that were really hard to play were PGM status. So if we go in here, Demon Front is one of the games that are really hard to play. A lot of people found out that it wasn't working. And then there was another one that I mentioned on one of the forums, which is Martial Masters. So you actually think it would say Martial Arts Masters, but it's Martial Masters. And to me, it plays like a Art of Fighting 3 when SNK changed their format. Because when Street Fighter from Capcom, the third generation, third strike, second impact, which are all the same, they introduced a new fluidity style with the characters. So if you notice, the characters look totally different. And that Street Fighter is supposed to be where the characters are grown now. But if you looked at the style, it was totally different from Street Fighter 2. I think Street Fighter Alpha either came before or after, I don't know. But the character style was different. So SNK followed up with the same with Art of Fighting 3. They looked different from Art of Fighting 1 and 2. And here, PGM, Poly Game Master, they followed up with the same thing with theirs, and I'll show you. Okay, let's get this started. Just some coins right here. Gives you great time too, and you know, like 10 seconds, you have like 20 some seconds to pick somebody. I'm gonna get this guy right here. Now if you look at the character animation, it looks really good, especially for this being a game back in the day. I mean, these actual character models can rival the character models that we have now for 2D. I mean, it really looks good. Now, I'm not talking about the 3D rendered 2D models. No, I'm not talking about that, like the new Street Fighters and things like that. I'm strictly talking like Guilty Gear, things like that, 2D. And the sprites, everything, they're really good. So I really, really like this. Like I said, PGM was kind of like a Neo Geo. Like the carts were the same size as the MBS and the AES. They had similar systems. This guy is like really giving me a run for my money. Okay, that's my long kick. Okay. Oh, whoa. Oh, this is it. Ah. Draw, okay. We'll see if it's gonna be a draw again though. Midget. My long kick is just not doing it for me. There you go. Let's incorporate some different stuff. Come on, dude. Can't get beat in my review. No! No! This would be a killer in an arcade cabinet because, I mean, everybody would fall in love with just the way the game looks. How fluid the motions are and the moves. Come on. There we go. And then you know how you get out, select and start, so. And the selections are great. I mean, the artwork, the metadata. I mean, I like that he categorized everything because a lot of times you get like a whole bunch of games and some work, some don't. So he did really good with this image. I didn't know they had that one on there. So as you can see, I'll go down. Gunbird was really good too because the first time I was introduced to that was the Dreamcast and I never knew that there was a Gunbird one. Of course, you know, there's two, there's gonna be one, but I never played it, so. Let's go out of here and let's go down to where the games are. And as you can see, here are all the games now that are not in the categories of the folders. I know Spider-Man was a really hard one to get to work too. People were saying they had problems with Spider-Man, so does he have that on here? Let's see. I'm assuming if I go into the Sega folder, it'll be there. So let's go back up to the Sega folder. Okay, so here it is, Spider-Man the arcade game. Let's check this out. Winners don't use drugs. That's true.
Spider-Man.
I can honestly say that I am a drug-free guy. I haven't done anything, cigarettes or anything. But when it comes to ale beers, hey, I can't help it. Of course, I'm going to use Spider-Man. Go, Spider-Man. As a kid, that was everything in Chuck E. Cheese. Okay. So, Spider-Man works pretty good. That's another hard one. So, he must have really did good with the CHUD files and the BIOS for this. Because a lot of people, even myself, a couple of my bills took time to get this to work. We're gonna try two more that were kind of hard to work. X-Men was another one, and Metamorphic, which I think is in the Konami folder. Okay, so let's exit out of here. Start and select is always exit. So let me back up out of here. Dun, dun, dun. I have to get ready to go pay the mortgage in a minute. 1 second. Okay, let's see. Okay, we got X-Men 2 player, X-Men 4 player. Let's see. Oh, X-Men works too. Wow. Galisteo, you've done it again. And keep in mind, guys, this is all on a handheld. So you have all this fun that's portable to take with you. Again, GamePi 43, 4.3 inch display. You got the buttons, the four face buttons, the directional pad, the L and R buttons. Great screen, 60 hertz viewing from all angles. And with Galisteo's image, you can't go wrong. Let me give myself some quarters. Let me see. We always gotta pick Wolverine because he's just so hard-headed. Just doesn't play by the rules. I was looking on YouTube one day, and I was looking at the powers of these X-Men. And do you know, for Wolverine to be a person with only Andamanium, he can pick up 8 tons? Did you guys know that? I didn't know that. Really? Wolverine? So that means he can catch a car. I've never seen it in the movies, but hey. Hey, don't hit me. Don't touch me. Very fluid. Absolutely no lag. Latency is like zero. And I'm doing this with a controller. I'm not doing this from the Pi. I know with the GamePi 43, it would be no latency because this is a controller on board. It's a GPI. But I'm actually doing this with a 8-bit old Super Famicom controller, as you can see. And every button I'm pushing is like instant. So I'm taking it that he has a new updated retro arc on here, and he has it set where the latency is really good with these ports. Wow. I am really impressed. And Stoke, I travel a lot, so when I have to go to certain places and do reviews, or even when I'm at work, and you know, we all get our little hour break, I'm actually having fun doing this. Not your average tech guy. I do things outside the box that you guys will slowly find out as I drop more videos on the channel. Hey! Anybody ever do this when you're at the arcade? Just make the other guy walk? Oh, okay, let me stop. But yep, it works pretty good. So we're gonna go out of there. We're gonna test one more. We're going to find Metamorphic, which should also be in here. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I'm trying to see which one I like. Oh yeah, that one. Just for the heck of it. Let's just see. Oh no, I didn't want to pick 88 games. No. I did not want to pick 88 games. No, I did not want to pick that. What am I doing? Okay, 1 second. I did not want to pick. I did want to do Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I'm trying to see which one though. I just like the song, guys. Just the song. 1 second. Winners don't use drugs. Of course, Michelangelo is a party dude. No, we should be. Yeah.
This is April on the line.
Wow. Look how fluid that moves. That's crazy. That is crazy. I used to get a lot of lag on this with other images, but not this one. Wow. And I'm doing it with a wireless controller at that, which is known to give you a little bit of input lag. Wow, I don't know. Let me pay attention to what I'm doing here, okay? I'm gonna show you three more games and I am out of here. Okay. I don't think it's in this folder. Oh yeah, it's Metamorphic Force. To me, I will always say this, is what Altered Beast should have been, period. I mean, when I was younger, I was crazy about Altered Beast, but when I got older, the stiffness of it, how the characters move, how slow they were, and arise from your grave. I still do like it, but when you become an adult, you start to see things that you missed as a kid, and this destroys it to me. Hey, but we all have our opinion, right? Look at this. You know what it plays like? It plays like, kind of like X-Men and Rostan, the third entry of the game, Warrior Blade. I don't know if anybody ever played that, but Rostan was a great game. I think the second version of the game sucked royally. The guy looked like he was just, the animation just, it looked horrible. Rostan 1 and 3 are the best ones. I can care less for 2. Come on, guys. Look at that. See how the guy has more moves than just a kick and a punch and a sweep? Look at this. How can you think that Altered Beast is better? And on Galisto's image, it's just, oh man. I used to have someone, oh, there we go. It's over. Let me get to it. What's up now? Who wants what? What's going on here? Look at these guys. Look at this. Look at this. You mean to tell me that this isn't a good game? Oh, that's messed up. It's amazing. Got a little weather effects in the game and stuff. Okay, I'm getting too happy here. Let me get out of here. Okay. So we've seen the arcade. A lot of arcade games don't work in certain images. You get some that do, some that don't. Galisto really nailed this one. So we're going to go out and we're just going to go to a console real quick. My favorite is Nintendo. Oh, Scott. You know what? How many is Scott's? Wow. Okay. What's that? Oh, there it is. A lot of nice systems. I hope you guys are watching this as I'm scrolling through this. Okay. So my favorite was always, and I know it's going to be like, oh, why would you pick that? That's so simple. But this was one of my favorite games. Let me see. Actually, let me pick something different. Should I? Oh, there's no screenshot for that one. Okay. Two. Tiny Toons. Is that a good one to show off real quick? No. Oh, okay. I know what I'm going to show you. Urban Champion. What's up? Get off this turf. I'm going to protect these people. And you're still pushing me back. But that means nothing. Because my master trained me. And you're not dropping plants on my head. Oh. That's funny. That's fine. Well, let me stop, guys. I have to say that this is a great image. He's outdone himself from the first image that I reviewed. As you can see, he's got the Kodi Media Center settings, still the system settings, which is really cool because you can see everything right there. From your language to your keyboard, your disk usage, your version. You can also, with Recall Box, update to the latest version from your OS, which is really good. You have your game settings, you know, your ratio, which if you just want all your games to be at a 16:9 or whatever you choose to be, you can do it from here. Your rewind, your auto save, your press twice to quit game. Shader set, where you can have all your games set to a certain shader instead of doing it individually. Your control settings, your UI, which you can really do a lot when it comes to your theme, more than RetroPie. You have the carousel animation, transition style, theme set, theme configuration. So, I mean, it's really good. Update your game list whenever you add folders or games. It's just really good to do everything from the actual screen instead of going into various menus like RetroPie. So I really like about Recall Box. The scraper has gotten better, but he's done a lot with the artwork. I mean, you can just look. He has it set to the side right there. You can just see the actual cover, the game you're playing. It's really good. The metadata, everything's categorized real good. And if I were to even ask him to implement something, it would possibly be like the games that are hard to get. Like, let's say, if I were to go to, because of course, like I told you guys before, I am a Neo Geo fan, and you would seriously be shocked if you saw my Neo Geo collection. And here, like Cross Swords 2, it was a CD-ROM that was converted. I think it started on the Wii store when the Wii was out, where they had the Neo Geo. Someone must have got it, ripped it, converted it to where you can play it from CD form. Another would be, well, he's got Ironclad, that's another one, that's another CD game that was ripped to be played in cartridge form. So besides that, to me the image is perfect. I like it a lot. I like everything that he's done with it. Kudos, Galistio, and I look forward to more of your work. This is my review of his new image. I hope you guys like it. Please like and subscribe. Tech Made Simple. You guys have a great one.